We are live from Porch Time Studios. It is Monday Music Hour. We'd like to thank our sponsors, American Basement Solutions, Wellsprings with Bob Goodrum, Blandon Boys Lawn Care, Reps Fitness. I really need to go to that, Rob. I got like COVID 65 working here. So. just winging it. And now, the host of Monday Music Hour, Rob Helm.
It's kind of growing on me.
You like it, don't you?
Oh, yeah. Not really. You would. Yeah. Hey, welcome, everybody. This is, I guess, round three. It's called round three of our Music Mondays.
I'm toast.
I cannot tell you how pumped I am here. This room is full of unbelievable talented people. And it's a great night. Well, Vic's here, but no, I'm just kidding. Sorry, Vic. Vic knows I love you. This is awesome night. We got Chicken Bone, which is members of Taste Like Chicken, and Darren plays in different bands. He plays in like 12 different bands. Mindy, who else you play with?
Mindy and Eddie.
But we got the one and only. Now, I'm telling you, when I sent this email out to her and asked her, I couldn't believe she said yes, and I'm so grateful. We're going to get the show kicked off. I like, because we call it Music Monday, we get it started right off with that. Ladies and gentlemen, please make welcome one of Indiana's greatest artists, Jennie DeVoe. No pressure.
Oh, we can clap. There it is.
Thank you. Paul Holdman.
Paul Holdman on guitar.
They say there's a star no one will tell. There's a truth about heaven and hell. They say there's a man who will finally understand. When you find him, you know he's the one. There are whispers, it's true, and clouds in your view, but you blindly keep crawling along. So you drink from the cup. There's never enough. Once you found true love, they say there's a magic so very tragic. You give up your life for true love. You need it so badly, so very sadly. True love is ruin of you. There's a whispers, it's true, in clouds in your view, but you blindly keep crawling along. So you drink from the cup, but it's never enough. Once you found true love.
That's a brand new song. brand new song, correct?
No.
Oh, I thought that was you.
That's
said
from
that.
Radiator.
That's from Radiator.
Oh, okay.
Speak with us.
But that is your song, though, correct?
Yes, that is awesome. My song.
Great job, Jennie DeVoe, Paul
Thank
Holman
you.
On guitar.
Awesome.
Let's keep the music going. Let's get right into it. Vic, are you guys ready to do one?
Sure.
Yeah.
All right. We got over here, we got Chicken Bone with us. We got Vic Coons on piano. We got
that would be scary.
What I said, no, Darren Vincent's on piano. Vic Coons is on guitar. Lita Gentry and Mindy Britt are on the vocals here.
Yeah,
it's all yours, guys. Kick it off.
We're backing up now.
A little Chicken Bone. Chicken Bone, everybody. Great job.
Good.
A little jamming over with Paul. Got it going.
That's great.
All right, now, what we've done here, this is our third week in a row. And we've got guests booked all the way up till June. But we've been asking questions to the different artists. Some questions are tough. Some questions are easy.
Oh, man.
Some are on the spot. Some we might take from our listener or watchers, I should say. But
viewers.
Yeah, our viewers, I should say. Right now, though, Jennie?
No.
Yeah.
Okay.
You guys can be thinking, because you're going to get the same question. I'll give each one of you an opportunity here. But, you know, it's important, because where I come from, my dad was Bobby Helms. He's the one that did Jingle Bell Rock, and I've been in this business my whole life. It's cool to see and hear from different people how it got, what made you get rolling in this. So my first question for you guys, what inspired you, Jennie, to be in music, to make music? What said, this is it? This is what I want to do this. There was something that made it happen.
Well, I had always wanted to do this, but my parents didn't really encourage anything even remotely like this. So I actually went to school to do counseling psychology and got a degree in that and telecommunications. And then my husband and I got married right after college and moved to Indianapolis. And in, within 4 weeks, I was in a band again. That's what I did like all through high school. I would skip school, get dropped off at school, and go through the swimming pool, out the swimming pool door, and hang out with some unsavory characters during the day. And they were doing a lot of smoking and drinking. I really did just want to sing. I mean, I really did. And even though I had a degree, I just kind of felt like I was being put where I was supposed to be put. So I just, that's all I did. I never really looked back. So, and then I started singing jingles and I just kept landing in spots. So I'm grateful for where I've landed. So I don't think I've devised this path. It's been kind of, I've been really willing to land a lot of different places, and it's been, I'm real grateful for it.
Cool. Lita, what about you?
Oh boy. Well, my parents did encourage singing, and I grew up doing some theater, but I got to a point where I just wanted to sing. You know, I didn't really want to do the whole theater thing. So, and I think I was inspired by my parents and some local musicians, Jimmy McDaniels. Back in the day when I was a little girl, I used to go sing with him, and he would encourage me to, you know, kind of get over stage fear and so forth. And then, Gary Walters, he got me started in singing with bands. He introduced me to you, actually working on that little
It's on my notes here, Lee. In 1994, we did my dad's Christmas album.
Yeah, we did. That's right.
Yeah,
and,
we did.
And Gary got me going there and got me an audition for a local group, Sequel. And once I started, you know, doing the band thing, it was just so much fun, and just, it was challenging, you know. And so I've just tried to work with as many people as I can over the years. To me, that's kind of the best part, all the different people you get to work with.
The relationships.
Yeah.
I mean, Mindy, what about you?
Gosh, well, I've sang, I guess, since I was little. My grandma sang the choir at church, and my aunts all sang, and my dad sang, and... So we learned harmony really young, at a young age, and I was singing in church. So that was very helpful getting started. I sang in school, through school, but mostly I was just always wanted to be a mother. And so we got out of school, and I had a handful of kids. And then I came back to singing, I guess, later, like in my 20s, later on in my 20s, and... It's been awesome singing with these local bands because I feel like I get the best of both worlds. I get to raise my family and be home all the time and also sing on the weekends, and I love it. It's great.
It's awesome. Hey, Vic, how about you, buddy?
My grandfather was a part-time professional musician. He played Hawaiian guitar. He wrote a lot of music. I have a stack of tapes still. I always say I'm going to have them put digitally transferred so I could hear what he was doing, you know, back in those days. But another thing was that there was a place, you guys may remember it, it was called Village Inn Pizza on Hannah and 31, and they used to have a house band there by the name of Roadside Table. And we used to go there as kids, and my friends would get their parents to go. We would just have this big group go. I was just always, as a little kid, like, I want to be like these guys. And it was really cool. I mean, it's
what it takes, man.
It just was, to me, that was the greatest thing. So,
Darren.
Whoa. Mine was a babysitter situation, actually.
Wait a minute. Whoa.
So my parents' work day.
Family show.
I have to say, it is a family show. Parents' work day, babysitter, her son played piano. I was six. So I would just stand there and watch him play. And they finally put me in lessons. From then on, I didn't practice as much as I probably should have, but she took me in, and I've been playing ever since. I just love it.
So cool. Yeah,
play with all different people, lots of
oh yeah,
lots of different bands, and
And you're a good booking agent, too.
I was playing most of dive bars that were around here in Indianapolis and surrounding areas. So I've just been loving it ever since.
Phil joined us.
Phil Pearly? Oh, yeah. Paul Holman's back here playing guitar with Jennie tonight, but Paul plays in the Wombleys and the Wombleys Rock Orchestra, and who knows what else you play with what all the other ones. But Phil, Frank Bradford brought your name up when he was here about gave you guitar lessons for a minute. Was that correct?
It was a couple months, I think, but
yeah.
He was a great teacher.
Love that guy.
Frank
Bradford.
Yeah, Frank's cool. Yeah.
But Paul, tell us, man, what did it for you, bud?
Well, my great grandmother played piano, and she played only hymns and church stuff and gospel music. My mom played piano. She played classical, and she played a little bit of boogie woogie. And there was always music in the house. But basically, once I kind of got a hold of her Chuck Berry records and saw Elvis Jailhouse Rock, kind of did it for me. And I just decided, you know. And then I went and saw Ted Nugent. My mom took me to see Ted Nugent.
And the guitar. I mean, it all looks like what Ted Nugent plays. Looks like what Chuck Berry plays.
I fell asleep in the middle of the concert because I was 5 or 6. But I just remember him swinging out on a rope and had his guitar. And he was running around. I thought, that's definitely what I want to do right there.
There you go. I like that. Okay, Jennie.
Yeah.
Now, I don't know about all you guys with Chicken Bone, but I do realize this lady right here is a songwriting machine. Are you guys songwriters over there? Just asking.
A little. Not much.
Because I'll go a different route with you.
Not to that degree.
We're in that direction, but nothing like this.
Because I'll go a different question with you guys on this thing.
Okay,
Jennie.
Yep.
And we've had some great answers on this. So.
No.
No is not a good answer. So sitting right there in that chair to your right, you could have anybody in the world, one person that you want to write with.
Oh, that I want to write with or write for?
With. You guys are going to sit down and make a song together. It's going to be a hit record for you or him or
dead
her.
Or dead or alive. Or
no, this one could be either one.
Real.
They can be dead or alive.
Paul.
Oh, shit.
No, I mean, because
I'm alive.
I'll tell you why. This is the reason. Finding a collaborator when you're writing that you can bounce off of. I feel like I write a lot of good songs alone. I write better songs when I add a second person who is willing to not kind of put a damper on or make it go a certain way. We tapped into a really symbiotic thing that early on we had no idea. I don't think even how to write songs. I did that with Paul, and I did that with my other writing partner, Brett Lottie. And it was just a matter of sitting down and beginning. I write lots of lyrics, lots of stories and stuff like that. And then I just kind of sit and... I would have Paul over, and I'd just start singing, and then he'd play where I was going, and then we kind of, there's this just kind of unknown, like, handoff of creating something. We've done it a lot where it becomes something, and you look back and go, I have no idea where that came from. You know, and I might start with a good line, I might start with tons of different things, but somehow it gets pieced together by, you know, an otherworldly hand. And I feel like that's why we somehow that's why we've met. I feel like it was sort of a divine
thing. You could have had Paul McCartney's as your answer, or John Lennon, or anybody.
I'm blushing.
You pick Paul Holman. You got it. Paul, you should give us some money, dude.
Checks in the mail.
All right, so I'm gonna go with you guys, because what you said, you get to perform any artist. One. Lita, one. One artist.
To perform with.
With. You guys are going to sing a duet. You're going to sing on stage with them. You're going to do whatever you want to do. But this is going to be the artist you get to be on stage with. And don't say Vic Coons. Come on.
Well, I already got the number one right here.
Okay.
Mindy. Seriously. I mean, she's, you know, and it's because not that many women get to sing together. And that's been a real blessing.
That's awesome. I mean, if that's how you feel.
And it's pretty cool because, you know, for singers, I, for me, the older I get, the lower the voice gets. And you'll hear a song on the radio and you'll think, oh, I'd love to do that, but my voice won't. And with someone with a different range, we can make it work. You know, I can sing a little harmony with her. She can hit some notes that I can't. I can do a little here or there that she doesn't like. And it's just a great team effort. And I think it's opened up a lot of doors at this time in my life, you know, to be able to experiment more with songs. And yeah, absolutely. I've got the one. And Mark Broussard. That's a guy. Yeah, I like him too. But yeah. but I'm okay.
It can be anybody. It could be Elvis. Wade. It could be anybody.
No, Mark and Wade. I got Mindy. I'm good.
Mindy, I guess you got to say leader. You'll be in trouble.
How am I supposed to follow that?
Well, should I get one, Mark? I'm sorry.
Right now. I know.
Go ahead, Mindy.
Oh gosh, I don't know. I mean,
this is truth.
Obviously, I love singing with Lita. She's my biggest fan. Makes me feel so great.
I'm about to cry over here. This is pretty sad.
But if I had to pick an artist that I would never get with, I guess I'd love to at some point growing up. Reba McEntire is my favorite. Loved Reba McEntire. I had all of her first albums. I knew every single word of it. So that was my all-time
greatest. That would sound good. That'd be good.
Can you ask me that question too?
Lyle Lovett.
Well, you both got the same hair.
And I did get to meet him once, and he was just exactly how he is on stage. He was just like, you know,
he's so good.
He's just calm. He's just awesome. Got a calm thing, but it'd be awesome to sing with him.
Lyle Lovett.
Because he's
awesome.
Super funny, and he's.
Have you ever seen
amazing.
Him act? I've seen him act before.
Yeah.
He's good.
Yeah, I have.
He's
yeah.
good.
Yeah.
Hey, Vic.
Well, okay, I'd have to go two different ways here, okay? If it's just an individual performer, there's no doubt Paul McCartney. And I was fortunate enough, actually, Phil Perley and I, two summers ago, went to see Paul and sit on row 3 up in Fort Wayne, and it was a lifetime experience. But if it was playing guitar, it would have to be either Vince Gill or Warren Haynes of Allman Brothers.
Oh, yes.
That's my two ultimate favorites.
There you go. Darren?
Well, you know, the piano guys, you always got Billy Joel, Elton John, those guys. But I got to tell you, I'm New Orleans guy is kind of what I love. So you got your Dr. John, you know, but Harry Connick Jr.
Oh, I
Harry Connick Jr., very
guys.
Good.
And I met him backstage before after a show. And of course, I said, I play piano too.
Yeah.
That was a terrible answer. But, yeah, it's like it was so nice. So he was so nice. And it's just, to me, he is a amazing pianist all the way around.
I'd like to also sing with Harry Connick Jr.
Yes.
Well, now, who wouldn't? Yeah.
Okay, Paul.
Talking about singing.
Real quick, buddy.
Yeah.
You sing. You play guitar for a lot of great singers. But got one?
Oh, a singer?
Or no, I got an artist. Anybody, I guess.
Oh, I Wes Montgomery could come back from the dead. I'd love to play with him. Just to watch him and try to hang on for a minute or two. That's off the top of my head.
You'd be good in the Jordanaires, though. I think you'd have been good with Elvis.
Yeah, I would. Yeah, I would have loved it.
Yeah, I mean, because that's the kind of stuff that
I could hang with that. Yeah. I mean, to a degree, I could hang with that.
Could you imagine being with the King though? When I mean, with Elvis when he was on a roll. Could you imagine what that would have been like?
Yes, I can imagine that.
Yeah, we're gonna ask one more question, then we're gonna have Jennie sing another song. So ready to go here.
Okay.
Tough question. I gave this to Phil and. Frank, and they had a hard time answering it. Locally, I mean, we all live in this area, right? Basically, Indianapolis area or whatever. So, you're going to go out on the town, and you got to go see a band or a singer, local.
Oh.
And you get to pick one. Who are you going to go out and see?
Why are you asking me first?
Because you're going to stand up and get ready to sing after I ask them. It's all part of the plan.
I like to see Paul when he and Rebecca are playing. Something happened to me once I started. I mean, I've been doing this for a really, really long time. So I don't go out a lot because I know when I had my husband, when I had him marry me, I mean, I didn't make him marry me, but I don't think when he married me, he didn't know I sang. And then he sort of got bamboozled into every single weekend of his life is, you know, so, I mean, there are so many really talented people here. So I just, I like when I kind of stumble upon somebody, but I don't go out a lot if I'm not performing.
I understand that. I'm yeah. same here, kind of.
Yeah.
What about you, Mindy?
Well, probably same in some aspects because I have a family at home, so I don't get to go out a whole lot when I'm not working. But when we do get to go out, my husband and I love Split Rail. They're a local band.
Yeah, the boys. There we go.
Caleb, I love Caleb Baker's voice. They do a great job.
They're going to be
love,
on here.
Yeah, I love there. That kind of music that that they play. And yeah, they're one of my favorites. So we'll make plans to go see them.
Lita?
Oh, that's hard. I mean, honestly, I try to go see the people I know. You know, like I would want to catch Mindy and Annie, and she's been telling me about Split Rail. So I'd want to go see that. I'd want to go see Darren, play. I'd want to go see the Wombleys again. I'd want to go see, your band. I mean, that's kind of fun. But that's one thing that when you're performing, you rarely get to see.
You rarely get to do it.
Your other friends perform, and that's the hardest part, you know.
Vic?
Presently together or not?
That can be your call.
Dead.
Good one, Jennie. I have a little different philosophy a little bit. If it was any band locally, including the past, it would definitely be one band above everybody else, and that would be Roadmaster.
Oh, yeah.
I was an Amen to that. Huge Roadmaster fan, friends with Rick Benick, and those guys were fantastic. I love following them. If it was anybody currently local, I love the Filter Kings. With Frank.
You told me about that, Aerosmith and all that stuff they do.
I love that stuff. And I can't. It'll come out Sunday. He was my guitar teacher too for a good while. So anything Paul's involved with, I'll go see. So it's like
Darren.
Man, it's hard because local wise, it's everybody you play with. Mm-hmm. I just want to come see them when I can't play. So, like, especially guitar guys, I don't get to see a lot. You know, Frank, Paul, everybody that's around there. I just love
good answers. Tonight.
Yeah, Phil Burley, Frank Bradford, those are my
guys. And Doug Hinthorn.
And Hinthorn, definitely.
Doug's, I got to get Doug on here. I'm going to make a call to him tomorrow.
Yeah, he's got to throw Doug in.
Doug's next.
One of the best.
Hey, Paul.
You created one of the most politically difficult. Questions to answer as a musician that plays a lot of different people. And everybody knows I love him. But the reason I want to say this name is because he was very important in my development as a blues player, which is a big part of my style, playing blues. And I would say Gordon Bonham.
Oh, yeah.
Because when I was 21, I was just fresh out of a metal band and trying to go to the open stages and, just doing dive bombs and the wrong sound, the wrong deal. And I saw Gordon and I thought, okay, I can, Gordon and Gene and guys like that, I can wrap my head around what they were doing, like harmonically, but tone wise and feel wise, I didn't have it together. I have my mom's old blues records. Gordon, he would invite me on stage and then eventually I played in his band for a while. And man, that just helped me so much. And that now, when I play with Tad Robinson or Rebecca now, I can apply those lessons that I learned. And also with Jennie or whoever I'm playing with.
Sure.
It's kind of a big part of my playing. So sorry for the long answer.
No, that's a great answer because we actually got Gordon and Gene Deere coming on here together.
Well, there you go.
All right, now let's get back to what we call this, Music Mondays. We're going to do one here with Jennie, and then we're going to jump right in with Chicken Bone. Miss DeVoe, are you ready? All right, ladies and gentlemen, is this one of yours, I'm sure?
Yes.
Hey, here's another song written by Jennie DeVoe. Take it.
Feel the sugar. Honey, you can fall for me. I'll be the girl who belongs to you. Yes, I smile and try to act so shy. You can just tell me you love me and that I have beautiful eyes. You belong to me.
You belong to me.
Oh, you belong to me.
You belong to me.
Boy, you have become the best part of me.
Kicked off with the
romance. Supposed to be kind of, you know, throwback, hence the sound, hence just the style, and thank you.
Hey, Jennie, if you look up on the screen, it's delayed, but that's my daughter asking that question right there.
What's she saying?
Well, it just went away. Oh, it's a question for Jennie.
Yes.
Right here. With your background in education, counseling, psychology, do you feel that has given your written songs a deeper emotional connection? Helped you heal, live, love, and understand.
Great question.
Great question.
Man, I gotta get her on here. She does a better job than me.
It sounds like she's counseling me, right? It sounds like she's dissecting me. But I think the fact that I was interested in psychology.
I think I've always searched for insight into people. People are kind of my favorite thing in the world. So relationships. Whether it's love relationships or friendships, I'm big at nurturing that stuff, and I like to write about that kind of stuff. So it probably did serve it a little bit. Yes, I would say probably did.
Thank you, Mackenzie. I love
Thanks,
you, girl.
Thanks, Mackenzie.
All right, we're going to turn over chicken. What we're going to do here, which I never do, we're going to do back to back. We're going to go chicken bonus song, Jennie a song, chicken bonus song, and then I'm going to bring out some other stuff here for you.
All right.
So we can keep it moving here a little bit. All right, you got one for us, chicken bone?
We do.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, that's fine. Is there anything we can get their vocals coming our way? Any of?
Not really.
I'm turning sideways a little.
Just sing loud.
Sing loud, girls.
Learn my lesson.
part.
Right.
Make me want to be bad. I'm just
yeah,
saying.
There you go. Jennie, DeVoe, Paul, are you guys ready?
Yeah.
Let's do another one. Chicken Bone, get you one ready. We're going to come back with some stuff.
This is called Healer. This is from one of the CDs.
Yeah, absolutely.
Some of the one with
fireworks?
No.
Okay.
That was awesome.
I need a healer to take me home. I need
just need a healer. I need a healer.
I need a healer too. This right leg's killing me. All right, chicken bone, what you got for us?
We're gonna go back old school, I think.
I like it.
Anybody wants to play along? More than welcome to.
I probably can't help myself.
Oh, we're getting everybody involved, Kevin.
I'm telling you.
Jennie, I know you'll know this. Okay. So feel free to jump in.
All right, I will. Okay.
I'm sitting on my shaker, so I'm hurt.
Yeah.
Are we ready? Yeah. Ready as we'll ever be, right? If you ever change your mind about leaving me behind, oh, baby, bring it to me. Bring your sweet love in.
Oh,
Chicken Bone. Wow. Speaking of Chicken Bone, if you want to check those guys out, go to their website, chickenboneacoustic.com. Go to chickenboneacoustic.com. You can book them at info. They'll come to your house. They'll play private parties. The way COVID's put us, we'll about play anywhere. I think band members will. You can get a hold of them at info@chickenboneacoustic.com or check out Darren at encoretalent.net. They'll get a hold of you anywhere. Encore Entertainment. They'll get you guys out there. And I know you guys are playing. You got a gig coming up tomorrow night, right?
Yeah.
At the Tax Man downtown.
Yeah. Anyway, called Tax Man Anyway.
That ought to be happening with the basketball all going on.
Right, yeah, right next door.
That should be fun.
Nice
should be a fun, yeah. Should
bar.
Be a fun
yeah,
night.
Yeah.
There's a new burger in the town. It's called Taxman.
There you go. And now, also, I want to bring this up because one reason I did this show was to help promote the gigs that we also have that, like RD Productions, is doing. I've got Tastes Like Chicken. We got you guys coming out on May 29th. You'll be at the Drink at the Creek concert series. Tastes Like Chicken will. And with the Nace Brothers, how fun is that going to be?
Oh, I love yeah. the Nace
with the Nace Brothers.
Jennie and Paul are both really good friends with David, Jimmy Nace, too. And so.
And we've got Jennie DeVoe coming
yeah.
to the Drink at the Creek concert Woo-hoo. Series at CRB Fest, which is over September 4th, which we had you out there last year. That's where we got 10 bands.
Go,
Jennie,
go.
10 bands in 2 days. I like it. Now, speaking of Jennie here real quick, Jennie, some of these people might not know, or they do know. How many commercials has your voice been on?
Talking just thousands, and then singing. I'm getting ready to sing something for somebody, but for 5 years I did all the Meyer commercials, did all of them, and it was wonderful. It was like I was like surfing a wave, thought it would never end.
What's the one about the community? It's a community. It's the Credit Union.
IU Credit Union.
IU Credit Union. IU Credit Union. Always love that one. Now, you can check out anything you want on JennieDeVoe.com. Go to her. You got a great website, by the way. I mean, it's just loaded with information.
Aww.
It's awesome.
Courtney helps me with that. She's fantastic. She posts the wrong gig sometimes, but she's fantastic.
Dang it, Courtney.
She's watching right now.
Dang it. You got a,
up there too, so.
You got a big gig coming up April 21st
April
at the
21st,
Jazz Kitchen.
Jazz Kitchen, 6:30 to 8. Paul's going to be with me. It's a special wow night through Owl Music, and it's just kind of a... We're going to do kind of a cool jazzy vibey set, and I've got some new songs and stuff.
The one thing I want to ask you about, though, is the on May 2nd, I'm not sure what this is, the Sounds of Hope fundraiser.
There is a thing for grades 9 through 12 that is called the Hope Academy, and it is for kids in recovery who have substance abuse issues. And so I just toured the place the other day, and I'm helping them with a fundraiser. They hope to raise tons and tons and tons of money because it's a charter school, so they need donations and stuff. But it's fantastic. And I'm going to try to tag Russell Brand in one of these because I was there the other day. One really great book I feel like they should have at the Academy is the book called Recovery. It's fantastic. It's kind of a groovier... harder hitting thing about the 12 steps. I can't talk. I haven't really talked lately. And right now I'm finding it difficult to articulate my thoughts.
Just be you, so, Jennie. Just be you.
I am afraid of that. I'm afraid that I am being myself.
I love her voice. So I love her. And then, Jennie, when you agree, isn't it wonderful when you reach kids? I mean,
oh, yeah. Yeah. I mean, one of the things back to counseling psychology was. My concentration at Ball State was with drugs and alcohol. So I had dated a lot of, I will say, unsavory characters in my day. And it created this interest in finding out about codependency and my attraction to people with issues. So, and I think women do that a lot. So I like, I've kind of counseled a lot of people in that, and I enjoy it. And it happens again, like people just kind of land in front of you. And there you are, and you do what you do. So my life is just unplanned.
I want to read something, then I'm going to tell you who it's by, which I think is pretty cool about her. You guys have a great talent here in Indianapolis. You know, Jennie is a great songwriter and performer, one of the hardest working musicians I know, Bonnie Raitt.
Oh.
How would you like to have that said about you?
Wow.
I mean, I love her. Yeah,
I mean, seriously, we're not talking about like John Doe down the street said, "Yo, Jimmy's pretty cool." Bonnie freaking Raitt said that. You know what I mean?
She thinks I'm cool. She was really nice to me, and I think that she's the coolest. And I still hope some. I mean, every time she comes here, she says something about me on stage, and we've only met once, but she knows I'm a huge fan. She knows I work hard, so
it's awesome.
Think, yeah.
Well, let's do another song by you and by you, and then we're going to go to this or that questions, and then we're going to have our jam session if you don't care. And then I'll tell about everybody about what we got coming up. Thank our sponsors again. But right now, Jennie, you got one ready to roll?
This is a brand new song. Paul and I have never even played this together. This is called Drunk on Your Love. And I wrote this. I knew Paul would add magic to it. So I think he just heard it for the first time yesterday.
Pray for me.
But see, I'm not even scared. Paul. I'm not even scared. So I hope everybody likes this. Took me all of this time to finally see all the reasons I just couldn't see. Love was a place I could be. To see what is left, to see what I feel for you, still scares me to death, but I still don't know. Oh, would it go from here? I'm not sure where we stand, but one thing is clear, I'm still drunk on your love, and I can't get enough. I try to lay it down, walking away, rising above. Spoken like a river, we're breathing like a tree, and we're falling like the sun does when the sun falls into the sea. Well, who you saving all your truth for? 'Cause I sure hope it's me. Who you gonna open up your heart to when you open up your heart so you can be free? See, I still don't quite know. Ooh.
See, I can't get enough. I drive a burning down, walking away, rising above. Oh, it is all just a lie. Lord, I can't get that high. Oh, baby, you and I, you and I. Oh, we both know. I'm still drunk on your love. Drunk on your love. Drunk on your love. Oh, hey.
Chicken Bone, you got one ready for us?
Okay, this is one we usually do late in the evening.
It's getting late in the evening.
After we've sung a few, but it's really fun, so what the heck?
We're going to try.
Be gentle, everyone.
We're going to try.
Then we're going to do a little this or that right after this. And then we're going to have our finale. So you guys, we did come up on a song that we all can do. Is it, was that correct?
We don't know. I think so.
We don't know yet. That's great. I bet we figure it out.
Jennie, that song was, amazing. Yeah. I just, it just.
All your guitar work was just.
Jennie's song just put it in a mood.
That was great.
Oh my gosh. It was just. I was just swaying. I was getting my.
Ladies and gentlemen, once again, Chicken Bone.
Oh boy. Okay, here we go.
Are we good with this?
Great try.
Yes. Okay. Wow.
A little journey?
I know. Right?
I like it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Woo! Yeah.
Wow. All right, Jennie, have a seat down here real quick. Wow, that was cool. Very cool. Very good. I know it's hard to hear over in that corner, but that's awesome.
The extra guitar is really good.
Thanks.
It was cool.
Yeah, I never actually played that song. I'm like, oh, really? What's wrong with me?
It's a great song acoustically.
Yeah, yeah, it is.
Nobody tries it acoustically.
You did a good job, man. That was cool.
Great. All right, this is our little part here. We have a little fun. This or that, or either or questions, wherever you want. No wrong answer, just your answer.
No.
Okay, Jennie. You say that a lot.
No.
All right.
Four for four.
And you're probably... Okay, Jennie, cake or pie?
Oh, I don't eat either. Oh, okay. Pie.
Pie.
Cheesecake.
Cheesecake. Is
sweet potato pie, sir.
Okay, Lita, cake or pie? You ain't got to tell me the kind. Just cake or pie.
Cake.
Cake.
Vic?
Pie.
Cake.
I like it. Very good. Very good.
Both.
Both. Yeah.
Yeah. Cake pie. Pie cake.
Pancakes, Jennie, or waffles?
Pancakes.
Pancakes for sure, buddy.
Pancakes.
Waffles if they're from Waffles.
Oh. Vic?
Waffles all the way.
There's chicken with the waffles. They're not pancakes.
Mexican or Italian?
Italian.
Mexican.
Lita?
Depends on the day.
Really?
Yeah.
See, so, you know, man, Los Reyes, baby. 7 days a week, I can do it.
Big girl speaks.
Mindy?
Mexican.
Vic?
Italian.
Mexican.
I like it. Very good. Good answers so far, I guess. I mean, they're yours. Well, whatever it would be.
They're the right answers.
These are a lot of food questions, but yeah. Oreos or chocolate chip cookies?
I'm allergic to chocolate, and I love chocolate. So that, I need another question.
Hey, what's this? No.
I actually love Oreos, though.
Yeah. Paul, Oreos, chocolate chip. Lita?
Oreos, chocolate chip.
Chocolate chip.
Oreos.
Oreos, baby. Number one. Let's go a little music question. Beatles or Stones?
Oh, no. I love them both for different reasons. Okay.
But I am glued to the Beatles channel on my satellite right now, and it's just the songwriting. So, yeah.
Paul?
Rolling Beatles.
That's a good answer. Lita?
Beatles? Stones?
I'm with Paul. Rolling Beatles. Two different times in my life, I go either one.
Darren?
That's a hard. But Beatles probably just for the songwriting and just the amazing. Yeah.
Phil loved this question. I'm going to go back and do it. Zeppelin or Floyd? Oh my
God. Zeppelin.
I'd say Zeppelin.
Floyd.
Floyd.
Zeppelin.
It's amazing, man. I mean, we're getting different. It's so cool.
Pink Zeppelin, I'd say.
Pink Zeppelin.
Dolly or Whitney Houston? Dolly Parton or Whitney?
Dolly.
Say Dolly.
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 Dolly
all the
way. Ooh. Unanimous.
But Whitney's voice was awesome, so is Dolly's, but Dolly is a phenomenal songwriter.
Whitney did a beautiful version of I Will Always Love You. It was amazing, but yeah.
She made Dolly a lot of money.
Yes,
the
she
Who?
Did.
Yeah. The Who or Van Halen?
Oh, Van Halen.
Van Halen.
Van Halen.
Van Halen.
Yes. Van Halen. That's what I wanted to hear right there. Okay, let's go a little sports stuff. You might not even know it.
No.
NFL or NBA? Might not even care.
Oh.
You just sang the national anthem for the Pacers, so I'd be careful of that.
I mean.
You get to watch one. What are you going to watch? NFL or NBA?
I'll probably watch NFL.
NFL.
NFL. My boys play basketball, so I'm a basketball fan. I'd rather watch that.
I'm a courtside season ticket holder for the Pacers, so I gotta go Pacers, even though I
used to take me, didn't you?
That's right. Paul used to go with me all the time.
I guess I'm a traitor over here. I'm sorry.
I sang the anthem the other day with my mask on.
Yeah,
so that
saw
was crazy.
That. Darren.
NFL. Adult juice would be nice.
Okay. Dog or cat?
Dog.
Dog.
Dog?
I like both, but if I had to pick one, it'd be dog.
Dog, definitely.
Good answers. Good answers. Because I'm a dog. Well, I can't say it. Frisky, don't get mad at me.
Cats are fascinating. Yeah. But I'm allergic.
I am too. But I got my last cat died at 21. She was 21 years old.
So wow. Amazing life, though.
Yeah. It's an amazing life.
Rich friend or a loyal friend?
Rich.
No.
Loyal.
Loyal.
Loyal. Loyal. Loyal. For sure.
Rich friend or a loyal friend?
Male or female? There's a reason.
I got you, Greg. I'm with you.
Definitely
alone.
There's a reason I said that.
Oh, Darren?
He's got to be loyal.
Yeah. Loyal, make rich, girlfriend. Yeah. That's what people think about. That
one. Yeah, you got
permission or forgiveness? Permission or forgiveness?
Forgiveness.
Oh, yeah, forgiveness. Yeah.
Never ask permission.
Caesar
asked.
Yeah. Permission or forgiveness?
Oh, yes.
Hey, girls, what am I supposed to answer?
Forgiveness.
Forgiveness.
Darren's going to say forgiveness.
Yeah, it's got to be forgiveness.
These are easy, Rob.
Beets or Brussels sprouts?
Both. I love them. Together as one.
Really?
Brussels sprouts.
Wow.
Yeah.
Beets.
I'm a beet guy.
Brussels sprouts.
I like Brussels.
Brussels sprouts.
Brussels sprouts for me.
Healthy bands here. What's the one thing you won't eat? Most people would say beets.
come back to me. I gotta think about that.
What's the one thing you won't eat, Paul?
Bad grits. Everything else is
sushi.
Amen to that.
No raw stuff.
Celery.
Really?
Poor thing.
Mindy?
I like everything. I don't really know that there's anything I don't like.
Liver.
Liver.
Like liver.
Liver. No, not me. Yeah, that's
I like
liver.
Liver. I like everything.
Paul or Vic?
I'll take the onions, but forget the liver. I can't.
I agree.
I'm the beet guy. I'm not a big beet. Yeah, I can't. Unless it's an ice cream, which I did have beet ice cream before.
Beet ice cream. Yes, that sounds wonderful.
Okay. This is our last question, and then we're going to get into our jam stuff, and I'm going to tell about the sponsors here in a minute. If you could open the show right now, you're going to open the show for the, and this person's alive.
Oh.
This person is alive.
Oh.
Or this band or whoever it would be. You get to open the show. They want Jennie DeVoe. They want Paul. They want you guys to open the show. It's a national act. Who is it? Like, it's just around the table. You know, we go this way.
I'd like to go last. Can I go last?
You want to defer to last?
Yeah, I'm going to defer to last.
Paul, will you go?
Yeah, I'll go. Jimmy Vaughn.
Wow. There you go. Lita?
The Eagles.
Ooh. Mindy?
I don't know. I know. I'm into a lot of the new stuff right now. Like, I like Tyler Childers and Pistol Annies. I like a lot of that stuff.
Yep.
Yeah, so, that'd be good. Pistol Annies. You
know. Pistol Annies, that's got Miranda Lambert in it.
Yeah. You'd open for them. That'd be awesome.
Vic?
I have to go with Lita. It would have to be the Eagles. As long as Vince Gillen.
That's a pretty good lineup when they put Deacon Vince Gill in, isn't it?
Yeah. Deacon in there, really, it's great.
Darren?
Daryl Hall lately. I don't know.
You ever seen that show they do?
Oh, love it. Yeah.
Love that show from Daryl's house.
Daryl's house.
Oh, wait a minute. Hold on. We're back to you.
I would say Gladys Knight or Ray LaMontagne or Bonnie Raitt.
Woo!
Oh. Bonnie Raitt.
Because kind of like they're all kind of just hopeful and. But all different.
Now we do have a question from the audience here that we'd like to get to from Phil Pearly. Hey Mindy, how do you get rid of a rooster?
Sounds like there's a story there.
Yes, Phil and I both have chickens, so
he said that on the show,
trade,
didn't he?
Chicken stories, but Phil, they make a good stock.
This is for you. Hard question. And then I'm going to talk about my sponsors and stuff while we get ready to jam on the last one. It could be hard. You might not be able to even answer because you've written so many. The favorite song you've written. If we get to pick one, Jan, this is the only song you get to sing for the rest of your life, and it's one that you wrote.
Oh, my gosh.
I want to answer that.
Yeah, you answer.
Butterfly.
Okay, thank you.
I love Butterfly.
Thank you.
I think I told you that 5 or 6 years ago, and it's still one of the best songs.
How do you feel about that?
I like that. I'll sing that one for the rest of my life.
Yeah.
Butterfly.
Got it.
Okay, because you got one cover song that you get to sing. One. Tough question, isn't it? You get one you get one cover song.
I know my answer.
What is it, Vic?
Soul Shine. Four names.
Darren?
Let's do that song.
Know.
It's
so good. Do you know it? It's like a,
yeah. Let's I worked out background vocals for Yes, let's do that instead.
Would you guys mind?
Yeah, that's
we cool. might have an encore because I think this What's is that? Going pretty well.
Oh yeah.
Darren, did you? Wait a minute, hold on.
Yeah, man, that's so difficult. It's heavy.
It is,
isn't it? Early Billy Joel stuff or
yeah,
something.
Yeah, I love Vienna. I love Vienna.
Oh, that's a great one.
I could sing Vienna every day.
I like that.
Yeah,
song.
Lita?
I love that.
Lita?
This is obscure. I'm going to go with
30 Days in the Hole. No,
I'm just that's a great song.
It is a great song.
She killed that one.
My Funny Valentine.
Oh, I love that song. Let's do that as our thing.
There you go.
Mindy?
Oh, gosh. I don't know. Probably a hymn, actually.
Yeah.
Like, How Great Thou Art, or
That might
Amazing
be.
Grace, In the Valley. I like all those.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
cool.
Pretty cool.
Let's get around to thanking some people to help us get to put this on. Our Porch Time sponsors are American Basement Solutions, Reps Fitness, Wellsprings, Bland and the Boys Lawn Care, Just Swinging and Apparel. We got a big Saturday coming up.
In JTH Construction Studios.
Oh, yeah, the JTH Studios.
Do the basement people do French drains in a basement?
That'd be up to Larry. Larry,
Larry
can
Ralph,
you answer
I bet
that question?
If okay. he's a good dude.
All right.
Yeah.
We got a big weekend coming up this Saturday.
Thank you.
My tickets go on sale this Saturday for Justin Moore. We got Justin Moore, who's 9 number ones. Got a hit record right now, brand new song out. We'll have him at the Morgan County Pre-Fair Country Concert. Justin Moore, Big Country, and Split Rail. Tickets go on sale this Saturday at Greg Ubler Chevrolet from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. It's the only place in the world you can buy those tickets first at 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. at Greg Ubler Chevrolet up on Highway 67 just there in Canby. And after that, if you can't get up there by 2 o'clock, they go on sale online at WCBK.com or GregUblerChevy.com. And don't forget, Resurrection, which is the Journey tribute we'll have out at Cedar Creek. Tickets go on sale for that. For all of our Cedar Creek concerts, they go on sale April 17th. So we got 33 concerts coming around to this area. And just looking so forward to it and keeping the music going. And you guys have heard, but last year, obviously, we were so blessed that we had 29 concerts scheduled last year. And most people lost theirs, and we got 25 of our 29 in.
I couldn't believe we got that one in. That's awesome.
We did it. I mean, we worked it out and made it happen.
We got two in with him.
Yeah, up at Mooresville and out drinking the creek.
Kenzie says DJ Dylan will be spinning the tunes at the dealership.
Oh yeah, he will be. We got it going on. We're gonna give away a chance to win a car, not on Saturday, but that's what Greg Ubler's doing at every concert we're doing. A lot of good stuff going on. I cannot even begin to say thank you guys so much for being here.
Thank you.
This show is just getting kicked off. We're learning as we go, asking the questions, letting you guys play your music. We want to promote you. Like we said, Jennie will be at the
Jazz Kitchen
in April.
April 21st, 6:30 show.
And go to her website for any information you need to buy her CDs or wherever at JennieDeVoe.com. JennieDeVoe.com. You can check out Paul playing anywhere and everywhere with the Wombleys and Wombleys Rock Orchestra, which, by the way, Paul is one of my – I love all my bands. I love all these people. But Wombleys Rock Orchestra is one of my favorites.
Thanks, buddy.
I just – it's something about it, man. When you guys kick into Cashmere, and it just kills me. I just got to lose my mind on that.
We got
to
follow –
the whole orchestra, it's just killer.
We got to follow up something for Jennie. He does French drains. So, yeah, Corey's – contacted him and he says he does. So
and then
okay.
Oh no, you go ahead. Yeah, no, Larry, if you can fix your drains, it'd be greatly appreciated.
Somebody's coming to give us an estimate tomorrow, so I'll let you know what that estimate is. It's $5. They said $5.
And then, the job.
Without a doubt, one of my favorite bands that you guys put is Tastes Like Chicken. How fun. That group you bring a great crowd every time. We have fun every time. Darren, me and you go way back because you've booked our band so many times, and I appreciate it so much. And Mindy, this is the first time I've really met you, and man, what a talent. What a great talent. And then Lita, honey. I mean, I met you in 1994 when we did Dad's CD up there, or album up there in Indianapolis at Jim Albrecht's studio, and I've known you ever since, and What a great voice. Great voice.
Thank you. Thank you. Well, we thank you. Thanks, Rob. Yeah. Thanks, Kevin. Thanks, Bethany. Thank you so much for having us.
So much talent in this room tonight.
The talent in here is unbelievable. Next week's talent is great.
Jennie and Paul. Gosh, come on. Yeah.
Next week on Monday night, 7 o'clock, we got Benito Di Bartoli. The guy only played for Eddie Money. He's a blues guitar player, great guitar player. And we got Peyton Collier going to be with him. And then the next weekend, I believe, is that when we got Julie and Trenton? April 12th, we got Julie Carpenter and Trenton Baker, which is just two incredible singers.
Yeah.
Really looking forward to that. I'll post the whole list coming up. But wow, what a night, man. What a night. Of so much talent that's been blessed in here.
It's great.
Just great to have you guys.
And Rob, everything you do, it's just been first class all the way. And thank you for some honor for the four of us to be in here. And
well, thank you. You know, when Kevin mentioned this, I was like, I don't know, man. I really did, because I just didn't know if we could make this work. And then I got to thinking about it, and then my wife got into it. She's the one who went and picked out all this stuff. We went to Hobby Lobby. He's like, hey, can we stop buying stuff or whatever already? But
good backdrop.
You know, it's just I love it now. I'm loving being here and learning stuff about people that we know, not just when I see you guys on stage, when I introduce you at the Drink of the Creek.
Yeah.
Now I know some stuff, you know what I mean? Now I know. And it makes us happy. And these guys right here, Porch Time people, these guys own this, and they're just beautiful people, man. They help. You guys don't even understand because you're not from here, but they help the Martinsville, Morgan County community so much. They've raised hundreds of thousands of dollars for people that are in need, for different things that have went on in this community. When people were down and out, they've helped them by getting on here and doing all kind of fundraisers. And when Kevin comes calling, man, I had to answer.
Yeah, that was good.
So, and then we got a sports talk show on Wednesdays.
Sports Nuts with Dean.
We got Billy's.
Do you want me to come in for that?
Sports Nuts.
Sure. Yeah. Well, are available.
Yeah, exactly.
I'll tell you who his next two guests are.
Okay.
Sam Carmichael.
Okay.
Who's golf pro up here at the country club.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then Jerry Seastein after that.
Okay.
So, oh, really?
All right. I should not be here.
And Martin from Martinsville.
Oh, Martin.
Yeah, he is my wife's first cousin. He's awesome.
Yeah. So, I mean, that's phenomenal.
Played for the Pacers.
Yep.
Played with Larry Bird and the Celtics when they won the championships. Good dude. Then a lot of stuff. And then Billy's Junk in the trunk. What a name. They got a show called Junk in the Trunk on it.
That's a good name. I got a great thing you could do. You could have a segment of the show and have Jennie and Mindy and lead on, and it's their picks.
I think we could just comment on stuff we don't like. Style, like your style's fantastic.
Gonzaga,
I like
just
that.
Keep it very vague.
Gonzaga, Michigan. If that happens, what's your thoughts, Jennie?
Yeah. Oh well, you know that's just great. It's a kind of a funny name. I don't really know how to spell it, but
Gonzaga.
Yeah.
In the cell, Robin. Tell me the cell.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think so too.
Hey, maybe we can get him to write a Porch Time theme song.
There you go.
We need that coming in, Jennie.
I keep telling Jay.
We need that. We need a theme song.
Let's do it right now.
Monday Music Hour. Monday Music Hour theme song.
Uh-oh.
Oh,
this is off the cuff now, folks.
Porch Time. Porch Time. Oh, Porch Time.
LLC.
LLC. Welcome to Porch Time. Porch Time.
Now they're all joining in.
Porch Time. Come on and see how much you get done on Porch Time. Larry is the basement guy.
Oh, yeah,
he's gonna be the French drain. French drain, French drain. For $5, dollars, dollars. Oh, on Porch Time.
Priceless.
Yeah, Porch Time.
We'll have to clip this and make it go. I am honored.
Perfect intro. Perfect intro.
We normally play the Sopranos theme song, so that's probably, you know, this. Oh, yeah.
We've went on. This is the longest show we've had, and it's been great. All right. No, it's been great.
Yeah.
Thank you once again. Like I said, big weekend coming up this Saturday at Greg Huber. Come out and get your tickets. But right now, we're going to take this show out. We're going to take it out. And I don't know, you guys have tossed around so many songs that you all know.
I'll just pop in and we'll do Soul Shine and I'll just...
You want to do
Soul Shine?
What were you going to say?
Well, you want to sing late on Soul Shine? I have lyrics.
Yeah, I'll take the lyrics.
Okay.
Yep, and I kind of know it already.
E-flat.
Now that's a true jam session when they're talking about doing it. We hope you've all enjoyed the show. We're going to take you out here.
I'll follow you guys.
Thank you so much, Rob, and everybody in here tonight. It's been phenomenal.
Thanks, you guys.
Phenomenal.
Yeah.
There's my beautiful wife. Awesome show. You know, thank you, honey. My leg still hurts, just letting you know.
It's E-flat. Ritual
key. I'm still stuck on porch.
So whenever we get a soul shine, just soul shine.
And then soul.
And then if I want to do, if I need to get, I just
right arrow. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Or you can, you can scroll your finger.
You can just scroll it up.
Just like that. Oh, it's okay. We got a little. Okay.
We're trying to figure it out. They are going to do a song here called Soul Shine, I'm guessing.
Soul Shine. Warren Hanks.
Let's hear the key.
Oh, you might have to change that word, right?
That's okay. I'll say it. I'll start.
All right, so now we got Chicken Bone and Jennie DeVoe going to do a song together. Soul Shine. Warren Hanks.
Oh, it's a G-man.
Not yet. Right?
We're ready, baby.
Okay. Yes.
I'll follow you. You can find a light, guide you through a cloudy day. When the stars ain't bright, shining bright, you feel when the stars ain't shining bright, you feel like you lost your way.
Let's do Bobby McGee. Yeah, we all know that one.
I'll get it.
Every show deserves to have a train wreck.
Hey, Rob, I don't think that was a train wreck. I say that was vulnerability.
That was a good answer. I said that again.
I definitely
we're just tuning tunes back and forth here. There is no wrong or right.
No wrong or right.
It's quicker change.
You can't find a light to get you through a crowded day.
Go.
All right.
When the sun lets you feel at home, you feel like you lost your way.
There you go.
You challenged her.
Let's turn home, but it's so very far away. You gotta let your soul shine, just like my daddy used to say. He said you let your soul shine, it's better than sunshine. Shine to the brink of doom. Yes. Who was thinking that I had made it, and I can make it on my own? Life can take the strongest man, make him feel so all alone. But sometimes I feel that cold wind blow through my aching bones. I think back to what my daddy said. He said, "Baby, move as dark as before the dawn." So when the sunshine is better than the sunshine, better than the moonshine, damn sure better than the rain.
people don't mind. Oh, we're all feeling so weak sometimes. Gotta let your soul shine, shine till the break of day.
Let's do spoken word on the bridge. Sometimes a man can feel this emptiness, like a woman has robbed him of his very soul. Dude, God knows she could feel like this.
This is too deep.
Let's do a broken down chorus. Gotta let your soul shine. It's better than sunshine, better than moonshine, damsel, better than rain. If your people don't mind, oh, we all feel this way sometimes. Gotta let your soul shine, shine for the light of day. Let your soul shine, better than the sunshine, better than the moonshine, dance over than the rain. Oh, you people don't mind, oh, your business way sometimes. Gotta let your soul shine, shine for the light of a day.
Great show.
Just soloed over that bridge.
Hey, I got an idea. We've been this far,
yeah,
and I know because this is going to kill it. Go ahead and kick Bobby McGee, and we'll just kick it out of here. Kick that out of here because this will rock. Because right. I'm telling
you. Guys, want to sing there?
Jennie,
do
you know we want to trade lyrics? Like trade verses?
Do you know it?
Like by heart?
I know it by heart.
Okay.
Do your speech.
Okay. Do your speech. Yeah, whatever. Okay.
It's cool.
Let's see.
You want me to go first?
Yes, ma'am. That'd be lovely.
What's your flag, Baton Rouge? Waiting for a train. The worst feeling here is fading. There's my jeans. My red thunder diesel down just before it rained. Put us on the way on the wings. But I put my heart out of my dirty red bandana. Friends on the promise. Windshield wipers, every time I was holding Bobby's hand in mine, we sang every song that got me. Freedom's just another word for nothing left to lose. Nothing.
Oh, one day
Thank you for tuning in to Monday Night Music here, Music Monday, Porch Time LLC. We look forward to seeing you guys again next week. Thank you so much for joining us, and God bless you. Have a great night. Thank you. And by the way, go Hoosiers tonight. Girl, Lady Hoosiers.
Lady Hoosiers.
Thank you guys so much.
Oh, that was
a lot of fun, right? I didn't mean to get all heavy metal.